well, you can see here, working in this mud rock combination, turning, moving, digging out a trench to put in that culvert and keep the water from the melt this year off my path. We've already got a culvert on this side right here, a lot of water, not as much as it was over this road when the thaw came, so it was much higher before, but I'm trying to avoid that next year by adding one more culvert. So I'm down here moving around and the track fell off again, so we'll watch and see how I get this corrected. All right, first step is to get it off the ground. What you're gonna do? Track off the ground. So we need to unbolt these bolts, and inside here there is the grease fitting to push grease into the cylinder and the fitting to take it out, or it might be the same fitting, I can't remember, but anyways, let's go to the side by side here. And what did we bring? So pry bar, wrench with socket. That one's a 3/8 to undo the grease nipple, and your grease gun to fill it up. Oh, and you know what? I forgot the wrench for the access plate. Anyways, I might have something in here I can use. Yeah, I got pliers. Okay, so I forgot the wrench to take this access plate off, but I've got a chainsaw adjustment wrench and it fits. All right, we're in business. Okay, let me set you up back here and we'll carry on. And I'm wearing a white t-shirt. The first thing to do is take this off. On there for now. And just flip this, tighten it back up, get that out of our way. We'll put this one back in there because I know I'm going to lose it. And then, okay, so this nipple does not come out. Let me try it then. I need a bigger wrench to get that larger one off. And that ain't big enough. Problem is I'm about a kilometer from the garage. See if I can get this. I don't have the right. Okay, so I don't know how tight I have this. Really tight. Anyways, gotta go get this socket. This one, as you can see, take this grease nipple out. Either a smaller wants to grab onto that, but I think it's like a shallow bowl. So I gotta go get that wrench. Okay, you are being paused. Actually, I'm going to give this a shot before I go back because it's a long way. The track It's pretty loose. And it looks like I might be able to pop that back on. So, of course, I didn't bring any rag either. Alright, let's give it a shot. I have never been able to successfully do that, and I shouldn't even have tried it this time, because yeah, you're not rocks, only rocks can get it on and off. Alright, so this one has the grease nipple where you expand the cylinder in the middle, but you can't, it's hard to get that grease nipple out, so you have to take this whole thing off, watch my hands there, this whole thing out, and then the grease will come out. My skid steer has two grease fittings, one, a smaller one, not this big one. This one is actually, I grabbed the right size wrench, it's 1/16 of an inch, that one there, so I've got it loose right now. So we're going to try to undo this. Pay attention to the camera. Actually, what I might do is I might just take the wrench off. There. Now, once this comes off, there we go. So there, that's out. Now grease is just gonna start coming out of there. Well, it won't come out until we start prying it. So for that one, I'm just
Just trying to set this knot in the mud. Right there. Okay, so when we compress this, grease will come out there. Let me see if I can get you in a good angle. I got gloves this time, so I'm not using my hands, but I am now well greased. Get you a bit closer. Watch that grease come out.
Comes out. Now, don't go half-assed. Push it back as far as it'll go. There's no sense making your life more miserable. Okay, so now, what I do so I don't forget, since we're done compressing, I'm gonna put this back in. No more grease coming out there now. This is back as far as it goes, so you should, by rights, be able to just grab this. By rights. But it never goes that easy. Take the slack off the bottom. You might need to use a little bit of a persuasion. I'm not blocking your view. Change the angle here. There you go. So the problem here is that you've got too much track hanging down. So the slack is below you. So you kind of got to lift up. Would be better if I'm not in a mud hole. But see, that one's on. I'm gonna let it down just a bit. Of course, nothing works unless it's on. Actually, that was easier than I made it look. I didn't make it look that easy at all. But anyways, we are back on. Back on the front spool. And we're on the rear sprocket, but the track is now extremely loose. So now we're going to tighten it up. So we're back together. Sorry for that. That was more drama than I needed. So then, in that grease fitting that's in there, shove this in and start. You see that wheel coming out? Tractor back up. Of course, I misaligned the hole here. All right. Check the tightness on that. Basically, this one here, when you start filling it, you don't have to worry about the track tension, and if you got it tight enough, because it won't let any more grease in. It comes out the sides, like as you can see there. So basically, I'm just going to leave that in there. When we're done, I put the cap back on when I just took it off. Oh, there goes the washer. So I'm going to I have to get my chainsaw wrench. Loosen this off. Put it back on. You see, I haven't popped the track off in this in probably 4 months because I haven't used it that much. But there you go. That's how you get the track back on. If you do it a lot, you can do it a lot quicker than that. Anyways, till next time.